talking about me. They laugh at me. They was calling me crazy. They're saying I was a child molester. And they, I mean, I was sitting back there with false accusations as if I did these things. I really was back there, and I didn't know when I was getting out. I did not know. They didn't follow. They illegally held me because I did not have any charge at all. I did not know when I was getting out. That was the worst time to do, because it's one thing if you know you got a month, you got 2 months to do. It's another thing, day by day by day goes by, and you don't know anything, and no one can speak your language. They're just looking at you, and they're just saying, and the one thing I did get was that the U.S. Embassy is holding me here. And I'm like, okay. And when I went to go see the U.S. Embassy, and they came to see me, I went to the meeting. I said, do I have any warrants? He said, no, you don't have any warrants. I was like, okay, so if I don't have any warrants and I'm not, I have no charge here. He said, they're doing an investigation. We don't know how they're going to play it out. We can't get involved legally. We don't know how to play it out. So I'm like, okay. So first week went by. I get one visit on Tuesday. You know, that's the only visit I get. And I get 20-minute visits. I go 24-hour lockdown in a dark cage, in a dark cell. There's a hole in the ground that you poop in. And you pee in, and it's back in the dark. And then there's a wall, like a wall with water that's coming up over the wall that goes into the, and it's dark, and it smells like pee and poop. And this is where you have to poop and pee and take your shower. So you would have to dip something in the water, and then the same sewage that was down there, it was really nasty. It was really crazy. It's basically torture, because, you know, no one spoke my language. And there was a couple guys in there that I was cool with that did speak English, like one or two of them that spoke my language. Outside of that, they was able to explain to the other prisoners that I was being, you know, falsely accused. And so I did not think it was going to drag out this long. So what happened was the lawyer that they got me, couldn't find a judge. This is so corrupt that what took me so long to get out is because the lawyer had to find a judge that would sign my release, right? And so it took a whole week for him to find a judge. And then the second week I was in there, I'm sitting there, man. I'm not,